The book that I will report is entitled The Girl Who Could Fly, and it is written by Victoria Forrester. Before we start in the story, let me introduce more about the author. So Victoria Forrester is a Canadian author and a successful screenwriter. She is known for her best-selling novel, The Girl Who Could Fly. It is considered a book list editor's choice and Bank Street Best Children's Book of the Year. Her other works as a writer and director are Cry of the White Wolf and Teen Sorcery. Victoria grew up on a remote farm in Ontario, Canada. After graduating from the University of Toronto, her passion for storytelling led her to write and direct a short film for the CBC. Currently, she lives in Los Angeles with her husband, newborn daughter, and ridiculously orange cat named Rufus. So let's proceed to information about the book. Fun fact, The Girl Who Could Fly is originally a screenplay option for the Paramount Pictures, but Victoria loved the story so much that she decided to develop it into a novel. So the title is The Girl Who Could Fly. Publication information is New York. Physical description is 329 pages, 22 cm. Language is English. Reading level is ages 11 and up. Genre is science fiction. And that's it. So the summary is, when homeschooled farm girl Piper McLeod reveals her ability to fly, she is quickly taken to a secret government facility to be trained with other exceptional children. But she soon realizes that something is very wrong and begins working with brilliant and wealthy Conrad to escape. So here is my graphic organizer. This is the main characters, the settings, the problem, the solution, and the main events. But before that, let's introduce them characters. So here are the characters that will be involved in the story. So first is Piper, who is our star, the girl who could fly. Bella, the girl who is very positive and she has the ability to change the colors of objects. Conrad is the boy who is a genius and also a bully. Violet, a girl that can grow and shrink as she pleases. Lily, a small girl with telekinesis, the ability to move things with her mind. Kimber, a girl with the power over electricity. Smithy, a boy with X-ray vision. Daisy, a quiet girl with extreme strength. Myrtle, a girl who can run than the speed of light. Jasper, a small boy who forgot his power. The Mustafa twins, Ahmed and Nalan Mustafa, who are able to create their own weather. Dr. Hillion, a scientist who tries to make everyone and everything that passes through her doors normal. Agent A agent, works at Insane. Norris Toll, a man who is in league with Dr. Hillion and calls himself Norris when he is more like an army general. Professor Mumblebee, another man in league with Dr. Hillion, but this one is the teacher of the children. Mr. and Mrs. McLeod, Piper's parents who don't believe in things acting different. And Millie Mae Miller, the big gossip queen in the lowland country. So here is my graphic organizer. So the main characters are Piper McLeod, Conrad Harrington III, Dr. Leticia Hillion, Joe and Betty McLeod, and Millie Mae. So, In settings, we have lowland country and Institute of Normality, Stability, and Non-Exceptionality, which is also known as INSANE. So here are the some of the events of the book, in the book, and the problem and the solution. So let's proceed to the summary of the story. Piper McLeod is a homeschooled farm girl with a secret. She's been able to fly ever since she was a baby. When her parents discovered her ability, they decided to keep it a secret from the rest of lowland country. Her mother, Betty, warned her not to use her power, but Piper couldn't understand why. She needed to fly like she needed to breathe. So ever since, she's been practicing her flying in secret. One day, Betty announces she'll be taking Piper to 4th of July picnic. Piper is excited, hoping it'll be a chance for her to make friends her own age. But there are already rumors spreading around Piper. Millie Mae Miller, town gossip, is convinced Piper is crazy. Things get worse when Piper tries to make friends with Millie's daughter, Sally Sue. The two girls initially bond, but Piper makes the mistake of telling Sally that she saw Millie kicking their dog a few days ago. Piper saw it happen when she was flying, and Sally still thinks Piper is somehow stalking her family, seeing past their fence. Worse, at the 4th of July ballgame, Piper has trouble hitting the ball. Piper is so frustrated that she flies into the air to catch the ball. The whole town is stunned. They believe her powers are evil. The next morning, reporters swarm her house, trying to report on the girl who could fly. She's also attracted the attention of Dr. Leticia Hillion, who works at a secret government-run school for children of special abilities called INSANE, or Institute of Normalcy, Stability, and Non-Exceptionality. Dr. Hillion wants to bring Piper there on the condition that she agrees not to fly anymore. The point of the institute is to teach children to interrogate with the rest of society. Her father, Joe, gives her a hand-carved bird as a parting gift. Dr. Hillion tells Piper that INSANE hosts children, animals, and plants that possess extraordinary powers, and she witnesses a rose that can grow as she descends down to the 13th level where the children live. During Piper's first lunch at the institute, her glass keeps sliding on the table. She realizes a classmate named Lily is telekinetic and is playing a prank with the glass. Piper manages to get Lily to spill her own glass on herself, and all the other students admire her for that. All except a boy named Conrad, who is rude to her. Later, Conrad bullies a boy named Jasper, who is forgotten what his special ability used to be, and later tricks Piper into flying. She is nearly expelled for using her powers. Piper does make friends with other children and learns their abilities. Conrad himself is genius level intelligent. Smithy has an X-ray vision. Daisy astonishingly strong. One day at lunch, Piper notices Bella is making rainbows appear, but she cries as she conjures them. Conrad takes Bella to the nurse. And then we make love. It makes
makes me feel so nice.
Later, Bella is about to graduate from the scene. Piper is ready to attend the ceremony with everyone else when Conrad abruptly throws the hand-carved bird from Piper's father into the trash. Furious, Piper attacks him, and the two students are sent to Dr. Hilliard's office. On the way, Piper breaks free, determined to retrieve her father's bird from the incinerator. But she is distracted when she encounters the growling rose from before. A machine is spraying a black, burning substance on the rose. She also sees a turtle slowly being crushed by a heavy weight. Piper feels sorry for both plant and animal and decides to help. She frees the turtle and it starts bouncing around the room. She tries to catch it, but it escapes through a window. Piper does catch a small black cricket trapped in glue. Piper frees it and names it Sebastian. Meanwhile, the scientists of Insane discover the cricket is missing, and security footage show Piper freed it. Dr. Hillion, assuming Piper is in her office, heads there immediately. Piper flies to Dr. Hillion's office to find a phone, hoping to call her parents for help. Conrad, already there, hangs up for her and shows her the phone is bugged. Then, he gives her the wooden bird, explaining that he had made a copy of it and shown it in the trash earlier. When Dr. Hillion arrives, Conrad covers for Piper, concocting a story to get her out of trouble. Later, Conrad tells Piper the truth about the institute. The food they're fed is tailored to each student to deactivate their abilities. They graduate only when they've lost their powers completely. He's been rude to her the whole time in an effort to provoke her into using her abilities. Because when they don't use the abilities, it will eventually be lost. He wants her to escape with him, but she won't go without the rest of the students. They attempt an escape, but Dr. Hillion catches them. She puts Piper in a torture device called Mold. The cricket Sebastian begins to sing to her, but Dr. Hillion throws a shoe at him and kills him. Overcome with pain and despair, she retreats deep within her mind. Then, weeks later, Piper is back with the other children, but her legs are broken. She can't fly, and she has forgotten who she is. Connor suggests they all try to escape without her, but Jasper refuses. He also remembers his talent. It's healing. He repairs Piper's broken legs and mind. The children lead a revolt and escape the institute, only to find Dr. Hillion waiting outside with a stun baton. Piper fights her, and during the fight, Dr. Hillion reveals her own ability to fly. Mid-flight, Dr. Hillion has a flashback to her childhood. So basically, the plot twist is Dr. Hillion has the ability to fly also, like Piper. She was flying with her little sister, Sarah, who accidentally fell from a cliff and died. Remembering this, Dr. Hillion suddenly stops flying and falls to her death, deliberately killing herself. Months later, Piper is back home, and Conrad joins her. His own high-status family has rejected him. This time, the annual 4th of July picnic is populated by Piper's friends from the institute, and they use their abilities to win the ballgame. Later, Piper tells Conrad that an invisible student from the institute, Jay, told her that none of them were safe yet, and that there was a secret place where they could all belong. That's that's basically the story of the girl who could fly. So let's get back again with the graphic organizer. So the main problem was all of the kids in the facility needed to escape from Dr. Hyun because she turned out to be evil. And the first solution was Piper asked Conrad to help her continue convince the other kids to escape at Insane and construct an escape plan for all of them. But they failed. The second and last solution was Piper decided to revolt against Dr. Helion, and they succeeded. So, for me, what I've learned in the book is it was all about faith, uniqueness, and acceptance. So, for me, based on reading this book, what I've learned is life is about faith, uniqueness, and acceptance. All of us, we are unique and we have different characteristics that make us powerful and creative in our own way. So we need to accept that in order to be successful in our life, because we have different different paths to take. We shouldn't compare ourselves with other people because what we have maybe not present in them, but we should appreciate what we have and use it as a key to be successful in life and to know our path. And this is my original art based on the book that I was reading. This is Dr. Leticia Hyun, the antagonist. And this is Conrad Harrington III, and this is Piper McLeod, the protagonist of the book. So basically, this is the girl who could die. Thank you for listening.